Hey everybody, Sexy Matt the Pharaoh Wizard here. So it's once again that time where I go over what we're gonna get from Marvel and give my predictions for what's happening. I usually do the next five movies, but I'm starting to feel like the shows, the Disney Plus shows, that is, are really pushing their own weight, and they're starting to do some really interesting stuff with them, so I'm going to include those too. So basically, instead of doing the next five movies, I'm going to be doing everything that we're getting in 2023, and giving as much detail that I could find, and see what happens, and give my own predictions of what's going to happen. So here we go, Marvel in 2023.
Ant-Man and the Wasp, Quantumania.
So the first thing we're going to get, it's coming up real soon, which is why I had to rush this video a little bit, Ant-Man and the Wasp, Quantumania. So what we know so far is it's directed by Peyton Reed once again, who of course did both the previous Ant-Man movies, and it'll be starring Paul Rudd as Ant-Man, Evangeline Lilly as Wasp, Michael Douglas as Hank Pym, Michelle Pfeiffer as Janet Van Dyne, and introducing Catherine Newton as Cassie Lane, or her hero name in the comics is Stature, and Jonathan Majors as Kang the Conqueror. Now, we're not really getting introduced to him as Kang the Conqueror, but we also are at the same time. I'm going to get into that. Now, here is the synopsis that I have found for this movie. Scott Lang and Hope Van Dyne, along with Hope's parents Hank Pym and Janet Van Dyne, and Lang's daughter Cassie, go on a new adventure exploring the quantum realm that pushes their limits and pits them against Kang the Conqueror. Now, here's kind of the big things going for it. So, this is the start of Phase 5, and sort of going on a side tangent, Phase 4 felt like what they do in comics after a big event, especially at the ending of like a big storyline and an ongoing comic. Usually the next one or two comics after it are pretty, you know, light and breezy and nothing too crazy in them. So I feel like Phase 4 was that. It was the end of Endgame and kind of setting up things going forward, but nothing too crazy happening. And so now Phase 5, we're getting back into building up what has already been dubbed the Multiverse Saga. And I think this is the right way to really do it. We've gotten the idea of multiverse from Loki and Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness, as well as Spider-Man No Way Home. So now it's time to really cement that idea. And they're doing that, of course, by bringing in the main villain of the Multiverse Saga, Kang the Conqueror. We kind of know this because the next Avengers movie is going to be Avengers... the Kang Empire, or something along those lines. Yeah, Kang the Conqueror will be fully introduced. So for those of you keeping close watch, Jonathan Majors also played who was at the end, I believe it was, in Loki. And now it's time, essentially, to bring him in as Kang the Conqueror. So where I see this going is that this is all going to take place in the quantum realm. There's going to be very little outside of that. I think now that the multiverse is opened up because Sylvie killed he who's at the end in Loki, that brought in, that kind of opened up everything for all the different Kangs to come in. And this is going to be like the worst Kang, but he's been trapped in the quantum realm by a previous Kang. And now he's trying to find his way out. He sees that with Ant-Man and Wasp coming in there, and they have their own way out. So he's going to use them to try and get his way out into the world and to conquer it, to do what he does. So I think that's where we're going to get Kang, is he's going to look like he's helping them at first, but then he's going to turn on them and be evil and probably kill Scott Lang. I'm kind of seeing that might be happening. At the time of recording this, the second trailer has come out, and it does kind of look like that. We're also going to get introduced to the official MCU MODOK in this, who honestly I think looks pretty cool. So yeah, this is going to be a really interesting start to Phase 5, and I think it's really kicking it off in a big way, and we're really going to be starting to see the gears and how this phase is coming together, and I'm really excited for that. So yeah, here's what hoping what we get in Quantumania.
Secret Invasion.
So the first Disney Plus show we'll be getting in the spring of 2023 will be Secret Invasion. So this is going to be starring Samuel L. Jackson as Nick Fury, Ben Mendelsohn as Talos, Colby Smulders as Maria Hill, Martin Freeman as Everett Ross, and Don Cheadle as War Machine. We're also going to be introduced to Kingsley Ben-Adir as Garvik, and Amelia Clark as Abigail Brand. And here is the synopsis that I found for it. A fraction of shape-shifting aliens, the Skrulls have infiltrated all aspects of life on Earth. So, this looks pretty cool. We also already have had a trailer for this. So it's going to be 6 episodes. And so I think this isn't going to be a full-on war with the Skrulls, as we saw in Secret Invasion in the comics. But this is more just a specific sect of the Skrulls that are deciding they're going to take people over. And I think that's where Talos is going to come in, kind of warning Nick Fury that, like, these guys are trying to take over. Let me help out with that. And I think this is where we're going to see S.W.O.R.D., which we did see in WandaVision. In the comics, S.W.O.R.D. is the shield but for space. And I think we're going to see S.W.O.R.D. actually be placed into space and becoming this protection unit for Earth, since we seem to keep getting invaded by people. I'm excited to see Samuel L. Jackson do a lot more as Nick Fury. I hope we see a lot of Don Cheadle. And, Colby Smulders is always awesome. So I'm curious to see where this goes. I'm a little disappointed with Amelia Clark because I don't think she's a very good actress. That's just my personal opinion. But we'll see what this does. It looks like it's a bit more down to earth, even though it has aliens in it, but a lot more grounded fighting. And we'll see how this fits in the wider MCU.
Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 3.
So this is the big one for me. Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 3 is huge. I can't wait for it. I'm a major fan of Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2. It's one of my favorite all-time MCU movies. And of course, the original Guardians is amazing as well. So this is my most hyped. I can't wait to see it. So this will once again be directed by James Gunn. And it'll be starring Chris Pratt as Star-Lord, Zoe Saldana as Gamora, Dave Bautista as Drax, Karen Gillan as Nebula, Palm Klentiff as Mantis, Vin Diesel as Groot, Bradley Cooper as Rocket, and Sean Gunn as Kraglin, and will be introduced to Will Porter's Adam Warlock, Maria Bakalova's Cosmo, and Shukwudi Eluji as the High Evolutionary, and I know I fucked that name up. I have not heard this name pronounced, so I am sorry, but he's going to be playing the High Evolutionary. So here is the synopsis that I found for it. After purchasing Nowhere from the Collector, the Guardians of the Galaxy attempt to make it a safe haven for alien refugees. After a brutal attack, Peter Quill must lead the Guardians on one last dangerous mission to protect one of their members that could lead to the team dissolving. So my first thoughts of this is, of course, we got in a trailer of it, so we can see a little bit of what's going on. But this is going to be the last James Gunn Marvel thing. I really think that he's got his full-on gig over in DC, and I think that's going to be taking up most of his time. And I think he kind of mentioned that this is it for Guardians, at least for him. And so I think this is, again, the last of the Guardians, or at least the last of this Guardians team. Guardians of the Galaxy in the comics has been many different teams, but I think this will be the final for this specific team. So what I think is going to happen is the High Evolutionary is going to be the one that attacks Nowhere, and he's going to steal Rocket. And I think the High Evolutionary is the person who made Rocket Rocket. And we're going to see his own planet that's full of animal people. That's kind of what he does, and we're gonna see Rocket's past, and it's gonna, you know, play into you know, how Rocket became Rocket. And I think we'll see some interesting stuff there. I think we're gonna see some interesting stuff between Peter Quill and Gamora from the other timeline. And we'll see where this goes. But I really do think this will be the end of this team of Guardians. Which, if Ant-Man kills Paul Rudd, we're gonna see the end of a lot of stuff this year. And it might be a bit of a sad year, but it'll be really good. James Gunn is always amazing. I love all his stuff, so I can't wait to see this. I'm very, very excited for it.
Loki Season 2.
So the next Disney Plus show that we're getting is in summer of 2023 with Loki Season 2, the first Disney Plus Marvel show to get a Season 2. So this is going to have Tom Hiddleston returning as Loki, Owen Wilson as Mobius, Sophia DiMartino as Sylvie, and Tara Strong as Miss Minutes, and we're going to have Kei Hung Kwan as a yet undetermined role. So yeah, there's no official premise or anything that I can find on this, and there is no trailer yet, so it's very interesting and it's very been kept under wraps. So the interesting thing is it is official from Kevin Feige that Sylvie killing he who is at the end of season one of Loki is what opened the multiverse. So it'll be interesting to see where they go with that from here. And I think this is where we're going to get some more Kang the Conqueror, either some of his past or actually have him in here. And I think it's going to be basically Loki finding out how badly they screwed up and trying to bring the Bureau back and trying to restore the sacred timeline, but ultimately failing at it and seeing this universe just open up and go into insane dimensions and a lot more crazy stuff. And I think this is where I get a lot more of the filling in of the gaps of the multiverse. So some more multiverse stuff. And I think we'll see where, again, this universe is really heading as we head towards Avengers Secret Wars and the Kang Dynasty. So we'll see where that goes. I'm pretty interested in this. I'll be curious what they see, what happens when we actually get a season two of these shows and see where it goes. So yeah, Loki season two should be interesting.
The Marvels.
And the final Marvel movie of the year, The Marvels. So this will be directed by Nia DaCosta, who directed the Candyman remake. So we're not getting the return of the directing duo that did the original Captain Marvel. And this is going to be starring Brie Larson as Captain Marvel, Iman Vellani as Miss Marvel, and Teyonah Parris as Monica Rambeau, who's also Pulsar, Photon, or Spectrum. They have not said which one she will be, but Monica Rambeau has been known as all three of those in the MCU, so be curious where we go with that. And we'll once again get the return of Samuel L. Jackson as Nick Fury. And there is a premise I found on that. I don't know how much this is true, but let's go with it. Following the events of Miss Marvel, Carol Danvers, Kamala Khan, and Monica Rambeau begin swapping places with each other every time they use their powers and must team up to figure out why. So I think this is going to be the first Marvel movie to really use the shows to its huge advantage. Of course, we got some of that in Doctor Strange and the Multiverse of Madness, but like this is full on, like if you haven't seen WandaVision or Miss Marvel, you are going to be totally lost. And I think this is going to pick up right at the end of Secret Invasion. I think Secret Invasion will have like a ending bit that will tie into this, and that's what's going to kick this off. And I think we're going to get more near-Earth space stuff, again bringing in the fact of S.W.O.R.D. becoming the new space shield. I think we're going to see some of that. They have not announced who the official villain is, nor will they. Maybe it'll be a secret one, who knows what happens. And I'm not sure how necessarily these powers connect to each other, because Miss Marvel, at least as of the shows, still has her bangle like wristband thing, which doesn't seem to tie that much. Carol Danvers gets her powers from the Tesseract, and Monica Rambeau sort of gets hers from the Scarlet Witch, who got her powers from the Mind Stone. So I don't know how exactly they're tying their powers together, but apparently they're going to be tying their powers together. So we'll see how that goes. I'm not sure what to think of this one. I did like the initial Captain Marvel. I'm really interested to see them do more with that character. And we'll see what they do with this team up, and it should be really cool.
Ironheart, Echo, and Agatha, Coven of Chaos.
All right, so basically, I'm just going to throw everything else that we're getting together in one last bit, but we're getting three more shows at the end of 2023, which is Ironheart, Echo, and Agatha, Coven of Chaos. So Ironheart will be first. It's going to have Dominique Thorne returning as Ironheart and introduce Anthony Ramos as the Hood. I think we're basically just going to see more of an origin for Ironheart and see her basically fight evil and develop her own suit and things like that. For Echo, we're getting Alaykua Cox back as Echo, Vincent D'Onofrio as Kingpin, and Charlie Cox supposedly is returning once again as Daredevil. Basically, I feel like this is going to be Hawkeye Season 2 without Hawkeye. I think it's basically just going to be coming off the end of Hawkeye and Echo kind of discovering where she needs to live in this world when everything she knew kind of was turned upside down at the end of Hawkeye. And, you know, kind of starting to build up of Kingpin being the actual Kingpin of New York. And we'll see some cool stuff there. And finally, Agatha, Coven of Chaos. All we know is Catherine Hahn is returning as Agatha Harkness. There's really not a whole lot of info on this yet, but it will be the last thing from Marvel in 2023. I think it'll be dealing with the fallout of WandaVision and Westview, and we'll see more about magic and how it works in this universe. And, you know, hopefully we'll get some introduction into some more magic stuff. Maybe some Ghost Rider or something like that. That would be cool. But yeah, not sure what exactly they're going to go with this, but it'll be very interesting. So those are my predictions for Marvel in 2023. It'll be really interesting to see where the universe goes and see how Phase 5 really builds up and where it goes from here. So it'll be really interesting. What are you most looking forward to in 2023 from Marvel? Let me know in those comments below. I'm Sexy Matt the Pharaoh Wizard. Until next time, hold on to your hold signs.